See here example 2. Solve y is equal to x divided by dx plus divided by dx whole square. It is a equation. It is equation solvable for y. See here solution. Given y is equal to x into p plus p square. It can be written as xp plus xp square. Now as earlier, differentiate this equation with respect to x. So the left hand side will be p and right hand side is x dp over dx plus p into 1. Plus x into 2p dp over dx plus p square into 1. So after opening this, it will be x dp over dx plus p plus 2xp dp over dx plus p square. This p cancels each other. So minus p square will be x plus 2xp dp over dx, or it is equal to minus p square equal to x 1 plus 2p dp over dx, or dx by x will be minus 1 plus 2p by p square dp. Integrate both sides. So integration dx by x is equal to minus integration 1 plus 2p by p square dp. So it can be written as minus integration 1 by p square plus 2 by p dp. Now left hand side will be log x and the right hand side is your integration minus integration 1 by p square is 1 by dp is 1 by p minus 2 1 by p dp integration 1 by p dp is log p plus a constant of integration k. So it is equal to 1 by p minus log p square plus k, since log p square will be 2 log p. It implies that log x plus log p square is equal to 1 by p plus log c. It implies log x p square by c. See here log x plus log p square is log x into p square. And this is log c on another side. So when you substitute it to the left hand side, it will be minus log c. It means the left hand side will be log x p square by c. This is equal to 1 by p. Or xp square by c is equal to e to the power 1 by p. It implies that x is your capital C into p to the power minus 2 e to the power 1 by p. So this is your value of x in terms of p. And given the given problem is value of y in terms of p. So eliminate p between this equation 1 and 2. That will be your solution. But elimination of p is not easy. So substitute the value of x in terms of p here in equation 1, then y will be in terms of p and x will be in terms of p. So this is our required solution. There is another example for your practice. E to the power y is equal to pq plus p. This is also solvable for y. Now see, first one is your solvable for x and second one is your solvable for, and the first is for a y and the second is for x. When the given differential equation can be put in the form x is equal to fyp, means the left hand side is your x and right hand side is your function of yp only, then we say that this it is solvable for x. See its different working rule. Differentiate both sides with respect to y. So it is dx by dy. This is equal to actually a function of yp and dp by dy. Since we are differentiating with respect to y, so this term dp by dy. This is an equation of first order and first degree and hence can be solved by the previous method. Suppose the solution is FYPC is equal to 0. Like before, the P eliminant of 1 and 2 will give us the required solution. Eliminate P between 1 and 2, then we get the solution. Or express X and Y in terms of P. That will give us the solution in the parametric form P, where P is our parameter. See examples. See, solve x is equal to y minus p square. See here, x can be written as y minus p square. It is solvable for x. So differentiate it with respect to y. So it is dx by dy is equal to, this is y. So it will be 1 minus 2p into dp by dy. Or this is your left hand side is 1 by p is equal to 1 minus 2p dp over dy. Or 2p dp over dy is equal to 1 minus 1 by p means p minus 1 by p. So dp by dy is equal to p minus 1 by p square. So dy will be 2p square by p minus 1 into dp. Now integrate both sides. So integration dy is equal to integration 2p square by p minus 1 dp. This is equal to 2 times integration p square minus 1 plus 1 by p minus 1 dp. Here subtract minus, subtract 1 and add 1. This is equal to 2 into integration p square minus 1 by p minus 1 is p plus 1 and plus this 1 by p minus 1 dp. So left hand side is your y is equal to 2 into integration p plus 1 is p square by 2 plus p plus integration 1 upon p minus 1 dp is log p minus 1 plus a constant of integration c. So this is equal to p square plus 2p plus 2 log p minus 1 plus c. So this is your value of y in terms of p, and value of x in terms of p and y is here. Substitute the value of p here, value of y is here in this equation. So you will get x in terms of p, x equal to 2p plus 2 log p minus 1 plus c. So equations 2 and 3 together, they will constitute our general solution. See another example, it was asked in our university 2004. The problem is solve p square y plus 2px is equal to y. Here we can write it as x is equal to 1 minus p square by 2py equal to 1 by 2p minus p by 2 into y. So differentiate both sides. So left hand side will be 1 upon p since it is dx by dy, and right hand side is equal to 1 upon 2p minus p by 2 into 1 plus y into differentiation of this with respect to y. So it is minus 1 upon 2 square 2p square minus 1 by 2 dp over dy. Or y into 1 upon 2p square plus 1 by 2 dp over dy. Substitute all these to the left hand side. This is equal to 1 upon 2p minus p by 2 minus 1 by p. This 1 by p goes here. So it is minus 1 by p. So it is equal to minus 1 by 2p minus p by 2. It is minus 1 by 2p plus p by 2. Take p common. So it is minus p 1 by 2p square plus 1 by 2. Now, it implies that y into 1 upon 2p square plus 1 by 2 dp over dy plus p into 1 by 2p square plus 1 by 2 is equal to 0. Substitute this to the left hand side. Take this common. It implies that 1 upon 2p square plus 1 upon 2 into y dp over dy plus p is equal to 0. Or 1 plus p square by 2p square into y dp over dy plus p is equal to 0. So it implies that y dp over dy plus p is equal to 0 since 1 plus p square cannot be 0. So y dp plus p dy is equal to 0. It means dpy is equal to 0. It means py is your c. So p is equal to c upon y. Now substitute this value of p in equation 1. See equation 1 here. Substitute the value of p. So we'll get x and y in terms of, you get only x and y. See here, this is after substituting, we get x is equal to y by 2c minus c by 2y into y. Y this is equal to y square minus c square by 2cy into y. This is equal to y square minus c square by 2c, or 2cx is equal to y square minus c square, or 2cx plus c square is equal to y square. This is our required general solution. As another example, you can see solve p cube minus 4xyp plus 8y square is equal to 0. The given equation can be written as 4xyp is equal to p cube 8y square, or x can be written as p square by 4y plus 2y by p. Proceed in the same manner, differentiate both sides with respect to y, and after some manipulation, you will get the solution. Next is your Clairaut's equation. You can see in its introduction. The equation of the form y is equal to px plus fp. See, p into x plus f into p. Fp is your function of p only, not containing x or y. It is function of p only. Where p is equal to dy by dx and fp is any function of p, then this equation is called Clairaut's equation. It is a very special form, so it is given as a name, Clairaut's equation. In order to solve the differential equation 1, we differentiate 1 with respect to x, differentiate 1 with respect to x, and then we will get left hand side will be dy by dx and right hand side p into 1 plus x into dp over dx plus f dash p dp over dx. So this is left hand side p is equal to p plus x plus fp dp over dx. So pp cancels, it means x plus f dash p dp over dx is equal to 0. Therefore, we will get either dp over dx is equal to 0 or x plus f dash p is equal to 0. So this dp over dx is equal to 0 will give you, see to the next page. X plus f dash p is equal to 0. The dp over dx is equal to 0 will give you p is equal to c on integration. Now eliminate p between this and the original equation, then y is equal to cx plus fc. Since the original equation was y is equal to px plus fp, so substitute p is equal to c, then you will get y is equal to cx plus fc. It is our general solution, or sometimes you can call it as complete solution of the given equation. Next, eliminate p between equation 1 and 3, then you will get a relation which is called as a singular solution, and it will not contain any arbitrary constant. So we will call it a singular solution. Therefore, the equation of the Clairaut form gives two types of solutions. First, the complete solution, which contains one arbitrary constant, and the second, singular solution, which contains no arbitrary constants. So it is all about for today's class. If you have any query, ask me here all your questions and note down them.